Hello everyone, welcome to Science and Tech series with Dr. Ved Rana. Topic for today's discussion is from medicine and health section. There is a viral disease which is dominating the headlines. So we'll be decoding Chapare hemorrhagic fever today. What are the positive agents, what is the reservoir, what are the symptoms, and what are the likely prevention and treatment to contain the disease, because there have been reports published by CDC America that this it poses a significant risk, because this is one of the diseases which can be transmitted to humans, and then human to human transmission cannot be ruled out. So we already are facing a pandemic due to a zoonotic disease, so this is another potential threat, but likely not as dangerous as the one which we are witnessing, because there is no respiratory droplet or airborne infection. But nevertheless, let's just have a quick overview from prelims point of view what you have to cover in Chapare hemorrhagic fever. So first of all, the causative agent, as the name suggests, it is caused by something related to Chapare. So it is caused by Chapare virus. If you go deep, it is belongs to arena virus family, and it is a type of RNA virus. So make sure you are clear with it that it is a type of ribovirus, and the family is arena virus. It's the same family to which the Ebola belongs, and we have seen how Ebola is one of the severe virus which causes hemorrhagic fever, and it has a high fatality rate. So that's what sets the alarm bell ringing in health authorities, because it causes the same Ebola-like illness. Now the reservoir, just like we have seen in case of Ebola, it used to be bat. Here it's the rodents, and more specifically the rats have been associated as a likely reservoir through which the infection is going to be transmitted. So once again, it falls under category of the so-called zoonotic diseases. Now origin of this disease can be traced back to Bolivia, because the first ever case was confirmed in the Bolivia, in the rural Bolivia to be specific, in 2004. Now the current outbreak is once again in Bolivia, but it's not in rural, it is in La Paz, which is, happens to be the capital of the Bolivia. So this is mainly a disorder, American, you could say, viral disease for the time being. And the nomenclature itself is related to, just like we had seen in Nipah virus, Nipah was named after a village in Malaysia. So similar way, this virus and the fever has been named after the province in Bolivia where the first ever case was confirmed. So its name Chapare is named after a province in Bolivia. Now the most important part is how it is transmitted. So it is likely to be transmitted through when an individual comes in contact with the infected rat. It could be its droppings, it could be its urine. So make sure the hygiene and sanitation is proper if you want this outbreak to be controlled. And once any human gets infected, then if the body transmission, any body fluid contact can result in transmission. This almost similar way just as in case of Ebola. But the good thing is there is no respiratory or airborne infection, so it is likely to be contained comparatively with much ease as compared to the one which we are witnessing. Coming to the treatment protocols, there is no specific drug, there is no vaccine available. Yes, the supportive palliative care in case of any hemorrhagic fever which we provide are available, because you will see the fever being high in this case, and then there are blood vessels get damaged and multiple organ failure can result in death. So generally, to contain the fever and pain, and to intravenous fluids are provided to maintain the blood volume, and that's what the supportive palliative treatment is. And coming to the prevention part, since there is no vaccine, the only way is to just keep your houses rodent free, and you can use the rat kill, the rat traps, and also you could use call and professional help to get rid of the rodents, and that's how you can prevent such outbreak. So these are some of the important facts, even though it does not directly related to India, but make sure any disease which is in news has to be covered, and especially the virus theme gets activated. Make sure you just revise your biology notes, what viruses are, what are their genetic makeup, what is their basic way of transmission and how are they classified, and then they can link you with the current viral disease. And make sure the topic of zoonotic diseases, how are the different diseases in which rats act as a reservoir, they can also be revised. So this is what we have in today's medical update on Chapare hemorrhagic fever. I hope it was useful in some way. Thank you very much. Have a nice day.